This week, it's the big reveal. How do I have my Apple Notes set up? Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pauline and this week I'm going to take you into my own Apple Notes and show you how I have it set up. Well, maybe not quite my very own Apple Notes because there's a lot of personal information in there, but I'm going to show you using my demo account exactly how I have it set up. And essentially what I've done is just mirrored my folders. So just to give you a few ideas about how you can set your very own Apple Notes up so that you get the most out of this brilliant application. Now, if you do get any value from this video, I would be most grateful if you would hit that little like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you would like to get all the tips and tricks on building your own productivity system within the Apple ecosystem, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you in to my very own, or maybe not my very own, Apple Notes, and I'll show you how I have folders set up. Okay, so let me show you the big reveal. This is how I have my Apple Notes set up. Now, for those of you who don't know, I've been having a lot of trouble in the last 2 or 3 months with Evernote on my iPad and iPhone. The current iteration of Evernote is not working very well on iOS devices. So in the end, because I'm using iOS devices a lot to collect my notes and add ideas, in the end, I had to switch over to an alternative, and I did, and I thought, well, okay, let's use Apple Notes. And for the last 2 or 3 months, I've been using Apple Notes quite a lot more than I've ever considered. And I've had a lot of fun with it. Now, the truth be known, is once Evernote gets its finger out and sorts itself out with the its applications, I will more than likely migrate back to Evernote. But for now, this is how, if I was to go all in on Apple Notes, this is exactly how I would have things set up. So of course, like always, I have an inbox because I want a place to capture all my ideas quickly without having to think about where I'm going to send it. So here's my inbox. This has been what I've collected over the last few days or maybe the last few weeks, because I actually noticed down here I've got one from December. And so this is my inbox. This is where I'm collecting stuff. This was an interesting one. This was a book that I was reading called Unstoppable. And what I did essentially was I took some pictures from my phone, actually. This was what I took from my phone. And it was just an image, but I used the scanner from my iPad. So I was reading my iPad, which is a screen, but I actually used the scanner to do this. And, you know, you can go zoom in on this. It's actually very, very interesting how you can actually, you know, look at these files. So there you go. There's a lot of things that you can do with the scanning device. Like I say, this is how you zoom in. I was trying to figure out how to zoom in there. There you go, that's how you zoom in. And so you can collect pretty much anything in Apple Notes, really good. Anyway, next comes up my anchors. Now my anchors are all the things that are truly important. This one I actually showed you last week. I've got my text for my YouTube videos here. I've got important numbers, which is locked, so it's like private. I've got important contact information here, and I've also got my coaching courses, coupons, and so on. Everything is in here. These are things that I need quick access to their information. If I get an email, I can get the link. So this is all here. Next up, I have a current folder. So it's not a notebook, or it's a current folder. And in here is my incubator. So this is all the stuff that I'm collecting, that I'm kind of working on, and just little things that I want quick access to, that I might have an idea. So like if I have an idea to update my coaching program or a Skillshare course idea, which I've had in the past, you know, all these things I can just throw in there. I've also had one set up for my perfect day, how I would spend my perfect day. These are just like things that I want to play around with. And in here I've got my content. So at the top, I always have my videos pinned to the top. So here you go, you can actually see this from this point here. So I always have the current week's videos pinned to the top. Courses, these are for updates that I want to do, and then my current work. These are things that I'm playing around with. And this, again, one of the things I really, really love about Todoist is that Todoist, Apple Notes, is that I can actually use my iPad and pencil. And then business, I've got my coaching in here, and at the moment that's all I have. So this is all my coaching clients that I'm, when I'm on a coaching call, I'm taking notes, and then I can just add them when I send the feedback. Now I've got self-development. So these are areas that I'm looking at the moment. So my project minimalism, this is like project one that I'm playing around with. These are all the things that throwing ideas that I'm throwing into here. So it's a project development note. I have an Oprah setup here, which I'm playing around with. Oprah is Tony Robbins's outcome, purpose, and action. Daily priming, again, it's something that I'm thinking about. This is how I'm actually working on building my own morning routine. And I got a systems review, which I've always have in my mental, because this is how I'm actually using to make my systems better. So self-development, physical, these will be things related to do exercise, what to eat after a workout. So perfect back session. So again, I've got a link to a video there, my goals and mentors. And then I've got my personal, which I've actually got nothing in there. Ideas Factory is for ideas that I have that I'd really want to throw in there. Read Review is where I'm collecting videos that I want to watch, or not just videos, but also podcasts that I want to listen to, and perhaps articles. So this is videos to watch, articles to read. And I've got a couple of thoughts in the inbox. And I've got all sorts of things in here that I want to review. This is shared, so it's anything that I'm sharing, one of which the note in there is I'm sharing with my mother, which is my home address here in Korea. And my archive, which is where I throw all my notes that I've finished with, but I don't exactly want to delete just yet. And I always have an archive, and that can be just deleted at the end of the year. So there you go. That's essentially how I have my Apple Notes set up. If there's anything that you would like to ask, please leave a note in the comment section below. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders, and calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.